Hi, welcome to the Subtitle Edit training series. In the last episode, we've learned about the basics of SE. Now let's learn some tips to speed up your captioning workflow. Before that, if you prefer using a different language version for the user interface, you can go to Options, choose Language. There are many languages for the UI. Pick the one you prefer. Here, we just leave it as English by default. We recommend using MPV as the video player here. Go to Options, Settings, click Video Player on the left. Click Download MPV Library. Then wait a few seconds to finish the download. Now switch to Waveform and Spectrogram. And click Download FM MPEG to use it for wave extraction as recommended. If you have watched our last video, we used F9, F10, or other shortcuts shown here by default. And you may wonder why there are so few buttons here or there over the interface. In fact, SE provides much more tools that allow you to assign customized shortcuts. Now let's just switch to shortcuts from the list. Now you can see a lot of additional tools or operations in the list. Trust me, it is a shiny treasure chest for you to explore yourself. But in this tutorial, we just show you how to assign the shortcuts for some nice tools we recommend that can make life much easier. In the search field, type Set Start. And now we can see a filtered result with some operations about setting start time. Then select Set Start Time, Keep Duration. Open the key list. Find letter S. Then click Update. That's it. Now you can use the S key on the keyboard as the shortcut. You can imagine that letter S stands for Start. Now you can see the shortcut is assigned successfully. Let's continue to set another one called Set End, Next Start, and Go to Next. Find it from the list. Select the letter F or simply press F key on the keyboard for a quick jump. Just imagine the letter F stands for Finish, then Update. Next, search for Go to Previous Line, set it to W. For Go to Next Line, change the shortcut from default to R. And don't forget to update it. Then let's use the E key as the shortcut for Merge with Previous and Auto Break. And D key for Merge with Next and Auto Break. Although we can always press Ctrl S to save the project anytime. Here, to make it even faster, let's use Q for Save All. Now, because we always need to import plain text to start our jobs, it is nice to set a shortcut for that as well. So type import. Here it is. We recommend using Ctrl-Shift-Q for this operation. That's it for now. By the way, just try right-clicking somewhere in the list. There are options to import or export your shortcuts in an XML file, so that you don't need to set up all shortcuts all over again when updating the software. Alright, ready to go. Click OK. By the way, the reason we use these shortcuts is that they can all be reached naturally by your left hand, so you don't need long moves across the keyboard,
or moving frequently between the keyboard and the mouse. Well, the default function keys for these tools could work better if you work on a laptop without a mouse. But we highly recommend that every captioner should work with a mouse instead of a touchpad. Of course, they are just the keys we recommend. You can always have your own settings. But wait, probably you may wonder what would happen if we use these single letter shortcuts when editing texts. Actually, we can't. So, in order to use them, we need to move the focus out of the text box. Normally, to do that, you need to click on other functional areas over the UI, but you can simply go to Options, Settings, click on Waveform, Spectrogram, toggle set focus on mouse enter. You can also toggle allow set list view focus on mouse enter in list view. I'll go back to show you how it works. Now I'm focusing on the text box. You can see the text cursor is flickering. Now I'll try to move the mouse cursor out of the text box. For example, when I press the E key, I'm actually typing a letter E in the text box. So in order to use the shortcut E, which is merged with previous and auto break that I just set, we need to first click somewhere else out of the text box, which is not very efficient. Now let's try the two options we just mentioned. Open settings and toggle them. Click OK. Now I'm focusing on the text box area again. When I move the mouse cursor onto the waveform area, you can see the focus has been transferred as well. The active workspace is now switched to the waveform, and there is a red border around it. Now press the E key. The shortcut is working well. Similarly, when I try to move the mouse cursor up to the list view, you can see the list view is now highlighted, meaning that the new focus is there. This time, let's try press the S key. It also works well. Now you get it. So remember, when you finish editing the text, don't forget to move the mouse cursor out of it so that you can proceed with other subtitles. At first, you may need some time to get used to it, but I believe you'll soon get it and enjoy the fun of being a captioner. By the way, there are a few quick tricks that you may feel handy. Other than the set start time button or hitting the F11 key on the keyboard, you can also hold the shift key and a single click on the waveform. Hold the control key and click will set end time. Hold the control and shift key together and then click. You can set the start time for the current line and offset rest, same as this button or the F9 shortcut. If you click while holding the Alt key, you can only offset the current subtitle. Holding the Alt key while dragging the start or the end time, you can offset gap easily. This is another very handy and important trick to remember. It only works for small gaps of no more than a half second. Now let's see how the whole thing works with a short demo. It may sound familiar to you. Be ready. Hi, welcome to the Subtitle Edit Training Series. In the last episode, we've learned about the basics of SE. Now let's learn some tips to speed up your captioning workflow. Before that, if you prefer using a different language version for the user interface, you can go to Options, choose Language. There are many languages for the UI. Pick the one you prefer. Here, we just leave it as English by default. Congratulations, you're now running like a rabbit. And do you even want to be a rocket? Sure, we have more cool tips for you in the following episodes. Stay tuned, see you next time.